played the number two team in the NFL on third down. On a short week, and that's a big challenge in itself. So the preparation will be key here. And there's many things that we've got to do well to have a chance to put any points up on these guys at all. This is a very physical, very fast, very quick defense, excellent personnel, excellent scheme. Against many teams, they just absolutely shut them down. And so we're excited about the opportunity. We'll open up to questions.
Marty, you talked about a short week, but it's a stretch of four games in 17 days.
Right.
Do you in any way have to lighten things, shorten things in terms of preparation to keep them as fresh as possible?
Well, no, not in the preparation part. We double that part. However, we do cut many things down just a little bit. The bodies and having the legs back, fresh bodies, fresh legs, and Coach Reed does an excellent job that way. Now, individually and as a group, they kick their preparation part up, the mental part up, and that's sort of how we handle these shorter weeks.
Marty, what have you seen from the O-line over these last few weeks as far as progression from early in the season?
Well, early in the season, if you remember, when we had guys coming in and out there, we had to overcome a host of injuries there. I've been proud of the offensive line as a group. Those guys, first of all, they've gotten better every day, individually and as a unit. And then we've been through so many fellows in there. And we lost our starting center. We've been through some injury situations there, and they've really started to come together and playing at a high level and playing physical and doing well in both the run and pass and other things that we ask of them. They're playing well right now. Now their challenge is to continue to play at a high level.
Or do you expect them to practice today?
Do I expect everybody to practice?
McCoy to practice today.
LeSean. Oh, yeah. I put that now.
Marty, the Giants defense has knocked out five quarterbacks. Is there something that they're doing that is leading to that trend?
Yeah, they're rushing the passer.
Well,
and this group, as you know, can rush the passer. And it's really across the board. Starts with their ends. But I will tell you, they're very good inside. They've got a good scheme. They've got a good blitz scheme as well, especially in their nickel type situations. And they do a heck of a job getting to that quarterback.
But they are better at doing it without the blitzes than teams you've seen?
They've got a new coordinator. He's done a heck of a whole new scheme, whole different scheme. And so so he brings his own flavor there, and he's done a heck of a job getting to the quarterback with the players that he's got excellent talent there up front. Cumulatively, maybe the very best defensive line, that I've seen up to date. They're very, very good.
It's a new scheme, Marty. Is it more like the one that Spags had in there than the one they had last year? Are they doing more similar things to what they did 2 years ago?
No.
No, it's totally different.
No. Yeah. It's a different scheme, different package. However, as the statistics show, very effective. They're very good, very well coached with great talent.
When you talk about the offensive line, the max protection, the extra protection you used against the Colts, and may have to use against the Giants, what about the blocking of your tight ends and backs in the last few weeks? Is that improved?
Well, they're a big part. Everybody's a big part of the protection, and the backs and tight ends always play a big part in that, as well as even the receivers and then the quarterback. But it does start up front with the five, and then the backs and tight ends are important, as are the receivers and the quarterbacks. We've got to be right on it against this group coming into our place here.
Marty, how much does Michael's elusiveness sort of help the offensive line?
Well, it helps in many different ways, go through and count the ways that it helps. In a way, Mike's movement, he's been, I've been proud of him because he's been very disciplined within his movements, and that tends to help the offensive line rather than the opposite of that. So So he's done well there, and that the way that he's done it certainly helps the offensive line. It helps in many, many factors there.
How has he developed that?
He's put the hard work and the preparation in. He deserves, and he's getting a lot of attention right now, and he's earned it. Now he has to do it the right way here. Because he's put the hard work, and first of all, he's got uncommon talent, and we all know that. But then he's put the hard work, both physically, he's put the preparation in, mentally, and of course, James Irvin hasn't prepared every week. So he's earned all the attention.
Marty, with the way he's moved, when the protection breaks down or whatever, when the pocket collapses, does he just kind of knock spies, out of the box that way? And do teams even have an advantage trying to do that anymore against him? And do you want that?
Well, I've got my own thoughts on it, but I want to say it publicly. We have seen that. We have seen that spies, and there's all different ways that you can do that type of thing. Many, many different schematically, many different ways to go about it. Generally speaking, that's fine. So we have seen, I'm sure we'll see more. And the one challenge that our offensive football team has is that when you've got a quarterback, and really, no matter what style, if he's playing at a high level, you will see different things from your next opponent, and then the next one, and then the next one. You will see that. And so that'll be a big part of this game going forward as well.